In this particular question, two particles move with uniform gravitation in a uniform gravitational field G. At the initial moment, the particles were located at one point and move with velocities V1 3 meter per second and V2 4 meter per second horizontally in opposite direction. Now we need to find the distance between the particles at the moment when their velocity vectors become mutually perpendicular. So we have two particles, 1 and 2. One is projected horizontally with 3i cap speed, another is projected with speed minus 4i cap meter per second, and they are falling under gravity. Gravity is acting in vertically downward direction. Now, at any time, velocity vector of 1 is equal to 3i cap minus gt j cap. This is velocity of 1 with respect to ground. Velocity of 2 with respect to ground is minus 4i cap minus gt j cap. Now it has been asked that velocity vector to become perpendicular. So for perpendicular velocity vector, the angle cos theta between them has to be 0. So cos theta is equal to V1g dot V2g by magnitude of 1 into magnitude of 2. This has to be, as for perpendicular, theta is 90 degree and cos theta is equal to 0. That means dot product of these two vectors has to be 0. Or we have 3i cap minus gt j cap dot minus 4i cap minus gt j cap has to be equal to 0, or minus 12 plus g square t square has to be equal to 0, or we have g square t square to be equal to 12, or t is equal to 1 by g root 12. If I put the value of g, then it is 2 root 3 by 10 or root 3 by 5 second. So the velocity vector will be maximum after a time root 3 by 5 second. Both are falling under gravity, so vertical component do not change. The relative velocity between particle 1 and 2, relative velocity between 1 and 2 is equal to 3i cap minus minus 4j cap. That is equal to 7i cap meter per second. This is the relative velocity. So after a time root 3 by 5 second, the separation between them will be 7 into root 3 by 5 meter, or 7 root 3 by 5 meter will be the separation between them when velocity vectors are perpendicular.